Good morning, children. Today we are going to start the first lesson of political science, that is power sharing. Children, all of you have studied the chapter democracy in class 9, and I hope I only taught you. The chapter democracy, all of you know the definition of democracy. Democracy is a form of government in which power is shared by the common people. So the chapter power sharing is interrelated with the chapter democracy. So in this lesson, we are going to study about what is power sharing, why power sharing is desirable, then we are going to study about forms of power sharing, and lastly, how power sharing is done in India. So first, let us start with what is power sharing and how power sharing is desirable. So before starting this lesson, the content of the lesson, I'll give you one example. The best example to explain power sharing is related to you. Children, all of you know, in the starting of the session, all the class teachers, they appoint monitors in the class. And most of the teachers, they only appoint one monitor for doing all the activities in the class. But I think all of you know very well, and this year also I'm going to practice this, that for doing all the activities of the class, I depute 2 to 3 monitors in the class. And all these 3 monitors are given the work, different work. Like suppose one monitor will help the class teacher in collecting the copies. Another monitor will see, perform the duties at the time of departure. And another monitor will perform the duty at the time lunchtime. So what will happen? The work will be divided. When the work will be divided, it will not be hectic for a single monitor. So this is the best example of power sharing. And if one monitor does all the work becomes very hectic and very burdensome. In the same way, our political parties and the ministers in our country, our prime minister in our country, he divides all the power between the different council of ministers. I only taught in class 9 regarding the cabinet ministers and the different departments. In cabinet ministers, the deputy ministers and the state ministers, they help and assist the central ministers. So this is the example of power sharing. Now, as in class 9th, to explain democracy, example of China, Mexico and different countries were given. In the same in class 10th also, to explain power sharing, example of 2 countries are given. But these 2 countries, Sri Lanka and Belgium. Contrast situation prevailed in these 2 countries. First, we'll start with example of Belgium. Belgium is a European country. In Belgium, one problem was there, and the problem was of linguistic differences. In Belgium, 2 sections, 2 community of people were living. One were French speaking and another were Dutch speaking. French speaking people were in minority in Belgium, and Dutch speaking people were in majority. But children, the contrast situation was there. The minority French-speaking people, they were given more importance, they were more educated, they were well-cultured, and they were getting more preference in the society. And the Dutch-speaking people, though they were in majority, but they were not being given any importance, they were not educated, they did not get any importance in the country, they did not get any employment, and they were very backward. So it was just disgusting, and they felt that we are in majority but we are not being given any importance. This prevailed for a certain period of time, but afterwards it happened that a cold war started in Belgium between the Dutch speaking people and the French speaking people. But the government of Belgium realized that if we will not pay attention to this problem of linguistic differences in Belgium, a day will come that our country will be divided, or the partition of our country will take place. The Belgian government, they decided that we will try to solve this problem, and they adopted a model named Belgian model. And in that, I'll explain you that what is Belgian model. In Belgian model, the problem of this linguistic difference was accommodated. They announced that in Belgium, federal system will be followed. Now children, all of you must be knowing, you would have studied in your junior classes that what is federal system. Federal system is a form of government in which power is divided between central government and state government. So the same thing was done in Belgium. In Belgium, the government announced that now we will separately divide the power between central government and state government. And in that, the thing they decided was that in central government, if 40 ministers will be there in Council of Ministers, 20 ministers will belong to Dutch community and 20 ministers will belong to French community. And the same was followed in state government. In state government also, in the division of ministry, if 20 minister belongs to French speaking, 20 minister were of Dutch speaking. And like this, everyone was satisfied. And what happened that in Belgium, Dutch speaking and French speaking, both the communities, now they realize that we are giving equal importance. Now we will also develop and we will also get equal importance in our country. And the third way, the third phase of Belgian model was that one more government was there and it was community government. And this community government solved the problem of education, culture and all these issues. And like this, everything was sorted out and still now peace prevails in Belgium, and now Belgium comes in the category of developed country. The second example is of Sri Lanka. In Sri Lanka, this model was not followed. The Sri Lankan government did not practice this. Now children in Sri Lanka, mostly two communities were there, Sinhalese and Tamilians. This Sinhalese, they spoke Sinhalese language and they were in majority in Sri Lanka. And Tamilians, they spoke Tamil language and they were in minority. But the Sri Lankan government did not give any importance or no voting rights were given to Tamilians. There were two types of Tamilians in Sri Lanka. One were those who were originally born in Sri Lanka and second, the Tamilians which migrated from India. But the Sri Lankan government said that as you live in Sri Lanka, you have to follow all the rules and regulations. You only have to speak Sinhalese language. The Tamilians did not get admission in the good schools. They did not get any type of job in the country. And due to this, the Tamilians, they decided that they will demand something from the government. And the demand was they wanted a separate state. And this demand was known as, the separate state was known as Tamil Alam. But the Sri Lankan government said that we will not give you a separate state and you will also not get self-autonomy. You have to do whatever we say and you have to follow our rules and regulations. And one another thing the Sri Lankan government did that they practice preferential policy, and in that preferential policies, they announced that Sinhalese will be their national language and Buddhism will be their national religion. And anyone, either Tamilian or Sinhalese, they have to follow only Buddhism. This was very exploitative to the Sri Lankan people and especially to the Tamilians. And for this, what happened, all of you know, a civil war was started in Sri Lanka. And thousands of people were killed, both Sinhalese and Tamilians. And what happened? The problem was not sorted out and the reason is power sharing was not practiced. And due to this, Sri Lanka, it was coming in the category of developing country. The country did not develop and the problem prevailed over there. Children, you can understand by example of both these countries that as power sharing was practiced in Belgium, everything was good and the country was developing. But in Sri Lanka, power sharing was not practiced. So from this example, you can understand the importance of power sharing. Now, in my second part, I'll discuss about why power sharing is desirable. There are two reasons why power sharing is desirable. The first reason is moral reason and the second reason is prudential reason. Moral reason means power sharing is spirit of democracy. Democracy and power sharing are related to each other. If you are talking about power sharing, we can never ignore democracy. And if we are talking about democracy, we can never ignore power sharing. As you have studied in class 9 that in democracy, common people views are always accepted. Whosoever is the government, whosoever is the prime minister, he cannot act as a dictator. So this is the moral reason of power sharing. The second is prudential reason of power sharing. Prudential reason of power sharing means practical reason. If power sharing is not been practiced, what will happen? It will lead to conflicts in the country. People will fight with each other. We can take example of our country. Suppose in our country, Hindus are in majority and Muslims are in minority. Suppose our government announces today that Muslims will not be given voting rights, or Muslims will not get admission in schools. They will not be preferred. What will happen? A communal riot will start taking place in our country. Both Hindus and Muslims will start fighting with each other. But what our government has done? Our government has given equal rights to both majority and minority, and the different classes are being given equal importance. That's why we can say that the prudentialism means power sharing does not lead to any type of conflict in the country. And if power sharing is not being done, it results into conflict. So children, these are the moral and prudentialism of power sharing, and due to this, power sharing is desirable. So children, thank you for today, and we'll continue this in my next class.